In our last video, we discussed the turbocharger and how it improved overall performance and efficiencies. In this session, we will be looking at what makes turbos fail and some key points when completing a repair of a turbocharger. The entire internal assembly is spinning at incredibly high RPMs, over 200,000 in some cases. High RPMs and extremely high temperatures spell big trouble for systems like lubrication and cooling. The three common areas of damage result from foreign object intrusion, lack of lubrication, and oil contamination. Foreign objects find their way in through the filter and into the hot side of the turbo. This can damage the turbine wheel by breaking off a piece or bending a vane. Either one of these conditions causes bearing wear and eventual turbo failure. Lack of lubrication can result from several sources. The most common is from improper maintenance of the oil system. Pushing mileage intervals or not using the correct filter will slow oil delivery and allow the turbo to spin without proper lubrication. Extended change intervals cause sludging in the components. When sludging is present, the shafts and bearings of the turbo will overheat, score, and wear. Oil contamination can occur from blocked filters or improper oils being used. These conditions do not allow proper lubrication to critical bearings and seals. This also results in premature turbocharger failures. When your customer is convinced the turbocharger needs to be replaced, be sure to remind them of the key requirements while replacing the unit. First, change the vehicle engine oil, oil filter, and air filter. Inspect air inlets to the turbo that may contain previous contaminants and debris. Use proper gaskets and avoid the use of liquid gasket makers. Use high temp anti-seize on all threads. Utilize a syringe to inject clean oil into the oil inlet port. Make oil feed connections, but do not attach the oil drain hose. Crank the engine for 15 seconds without starting to force air from the oiling system. Then connect the drain hose and run the engine for at least 3 minutes to allow checking for any leaks. Informing your customers of the potential failure points and proper diagnosing of the failure will go a long way towards making their repair more successful. Using a complete kit and following the installation instructions will ensure a complete repair that will last. That's all for now, and thanks for joining us.